Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab discussing common use cases of muxes with I2C-specific applications. In this video, we'll provide a brief introduction to I2C and discuss common use cases of muxes with I2C. We will start by discussing the features of I2C. Next, we will discuss common use cases of muxes with I2C protocol. These include bus contention, master device failure, and duplicate slave addresses. The goal of this presentation is to further the understanding of the features of I2C protocol and the application of muxes in I2C design problems. This video assumes basic understanding of the I2C communication protocol. For more information on the basics of I2C, watch the video series on training.ti.com or check out the application note, Understanding the I2C Bus. What are the common I2C features? One of the major benefits of using I2C is that the standard bus requires only two lines for communication, providing a low cost and effective way of communicating between multiple peripherals while saving on space. Other protocols such as SPI and JTAG require at least four pinout connections. I2C also supports multiple master control, which means many masters can operate the same data line on the I2C bus. I2C also supports a bidirectional communication pathway, where a slave device can communicate with a master device and vice versa. The ACK-NACK bit functionality also provides an extra layer of error detection between a master and slave pair. It helps to confirm that the correct addressing has occurred between the master and slave before data is sent. I2C supports multiple modes based on transfer rate. This includes standard mode up to 100 kilobits per second, fast mode up to 400 kilobits per second, fast mode plus up to 1 megabits per second, and high speed mode up to 3.4 megabits per second. TI's analog mux and signal switch portfolio has a variety of devices to cover the different needs for an I2C bus or system design. In the previous slide, I mentioned that I2C is capable of multiple master support. This feature is very resourceful, especially if you have two master devices that want to run the same slave at different data rates. Say, master A communicates with the slave device in standard mode, and master B communicates in fast mode. Being that I2C uses the same data line for each master, you can run into a problem called bus contention, where multiple master devices attempt to send data on the bus at the same time. This can cause inaccurate data to be written or read to and from the slave device. To make sure this problem does not occur, we can implement a 2-to-1, two-channel mux between the masters and the slave. The mux will act as isolation between each master device, only allowing a single master to be in control of the bus at any given time. Using the same example as before, we can look at another common use case where a mux provides a clever solution. As technology and analog devices continue to grow in their capabilities, we need a way to keep them in constant communication at all times. In this case, let's presume that the slave device is a vision sensor for autonomous driving. This is a sensor we do not want communication failures with, as it could put the driver at extreme risk. Our second application is master device failure. It is as straightforward as it sounds. During the communication on lines SDA1 and SCO1, the master device fails and stops reading data from the vision sensor. To solve this in a timely manner, the MCU can simply address the select bits to turn off inputs S1A and S1B and pass S2A and S2B. This will switch the flow of communication to a master that is still actively working, providing a quick solution to a loss of communication for an important sensor of a control system. In summary, a single 2-to-1, two-channel mux has successfully solved two problems that can occur when using I2C communication protocol. Consider that you want to address four different temperature sensors using an I2C bus. This time, however, you run into a problem due to all the devices having the same exact slave address of hex 70. When the master sends the address of hex 70 on the bus, this could cause a transmission error due to several temperature sensors trying to take control of the SDA line at the same time. Implementing a two-channel 4-to-1 mux is a simple solution to solving this address conflict. This mux will create isolation between each slave device and will allow the master to individually control a single temperature sensor at one time without conflict from another slave. In this video, you learned about three common use cases of muxes with I2C support. For more information about signal switches and multiplexers and their applications, search ti.com/switches.